Hi folks, welcome to the Astroform channel and thanks for tuning in. So today I wanted to discuss 5 tips on how to really nail or hack your polar alignment. Let's get started. So if you're new to the channel, my Astroform channel is all about astrophotography. And I'm here to tell you, you can start doing your own astrophotography from your backyard or your balcony, even when you are in a light polluted city like me. And on my channel I discuss reviews and also I share a lot of tutorials on how to set up your astrophotography equipment, how to accurately track objects in the night sky, and how to image those objects and how to post-process those images in order to come up with a high quality picture. So if you like the content, please consider subscribing to my channel by clicking on the subscribe button on the bottom right of the screen. And now that's out of the way, let's discuss polar alignment. So just before sharing those 5 tips, let's explain what polar alignment actually is. So polar alignment, it basically means that you align the mount of your telescope with either the north celestial pole when you're in the northern hemisphere or the south celestial pole when you're in the southern hemisphere. And why is this important? Well, if you really nail or increase the accuracy of your polar alignment, it will help you to more accurately track deep sky objects that are in the night sky. And especially when you're imaging fainter objects such as nebula, you really need a longer exposure time of about 4 or 5 minutes, which will bring out all of the beautiful details that such a faint nebula has to offer. And I'm also here to tell you that it is not so difficult to do a good polar alignment. So let's get into the first tip. So, tip number one is a very simple one. Point your tripod into the right direction. And for me, living in the northern hemisphere, it means that I have to point my camera into the north direction. And some of you will still have a compass lying around, but most of you will, I think, use a smartphone for this. So, let's fire up an app I have been using to determine where the north is in any particular location. So I'm using here, it is called Smart GPS Map or something for Android. I will put a link in the description below. And when I click on compass, actually it will show me a compass such as this one. And you can just move it around, of course, and be sure that your phone is calibrated correctly, of course. And then you can see for me in this case the north is over there, so I will have to put my tripod like this and so that my mount will be pointed north in order to accurately align my mount with the north celestial pole. So let's get into tip number two. Ah, the things you have to do for a good YouTube video these days. Tip number two. Oh my god, level your mount. Ugh. So it is always important to level your mount because your mount uses its declination and right ascension motors to accurately track objects in the night sky. And you can imagine when your mount is, or your tripod is a little bit unleveled, then this tracking will not be as accurate. And of course you can use all kinds of guiding software. Most of you will use PhD guiding, and PhD of course will correct for those inaccuracies. But that means that it will constantly send pulses to your mount to correct, and that leads to a little bit more inaccuracy in your guiding, at least in my opinion. And so always level your mount before starting. And another recommendation is I'm always using hardware for this. So I'm always using this particular leveler, and some mounts they also have a bubble leveler in itself, so you can use that. I also have used smartphone in the past, but I noticed that sometimes a smartphone is a little bit off in its calibration. So I recommend always using hardware to level your mount. And with that, let's go to the third tip. And I'm also curious, what kind of polar alignment procedure and what kind of software are you using to improve your polar alignment? Please let me know in the comment section down below. I'm happy to respond to that. So Tip number three is, put your mount into the correct latitude position. And I'm in the Netherlands, so I know that my latitude position is 52 degrees. You can look up your own latitude position, of course, by for instance, downloading a smartphone app. And I have one right here. It's the same app I have been using for the compass. So if I click on my location, and hopefully it will respond, yes. Oh, my phone is a little bit slow today. And you can see here, my specific location is, oh my God, Jan Dammers Casino Royale. Oh, this is some new place they put in the street here. It's awful, I think. It's the Netherlands. Anyway, so when you look at this smartphone app, you can see it's latitude 52.0969933. So basically 52 degrees latitude, and you don't get this kind of accuracy on your mount anyway. So basically I have to put my Celestron AVX mount into the 50 degree latitude position. And with that, I have some earlier footage on how I'm able to do that. So let's check that out and then move on to the fourth tip. So hi folks, the fourth tip is, of course, to buy a polar finder, or if you don't already have one, and use a polar finder to locate the North Celestial Pole. So basically a polar finder is a very maybe small telescope you put inside your mount. You can look through your polar finder, and the polar finder has some indications on where you should aim your mount at. So you use your Alt-S screws and your also your altitude screws in order to put the mount into exactly the correct position. But first of all, what you need to know is that Polaris is not exactly at the center of the North Celestial Pole. Polaris evolves a little bit around it. It makes a small circle around the North Celestial Pole. So you have to locate where you have to put Polaris exactly at a particular date and at a particular location. So I have this Polaris View app. I downloaded it. It's free on Android. You can use it. I will make a quick recording of it if my smartphone allows it. So here you can see that it's very simple. You see like a 360 degree circle, and the crosshair shows where the North Celestial Pole is. And the white little dot you can see over there, that is Polaris. So Polaris in this case is at the top right quadrant, a little bit in the middle. So when you're looking through your polarscope at, what is it? Friday, 20 September at night, Polaris should be pointed a little bit off center to the right and a bit up. So then you have accurately polar aligned your mount. So hi folks, we're at the fifth and final tip for the polar alignment procedure. And actually this is the tip what it's all about. This tip will help you to really nail your polar alignment. And I have to be honest with you, I'm cheating a little bit because I am using software. So tips 1 through 4, they only involve manual activities of positioning your mount correctly. And I'm using SharpCap software actually to really nail or to hack my polar alignment. And it really improved the accuracy of my guiding a great deal. So in this final part, I just wanted to show you how SharpCap software works. It is really user-friendly, in my opinion at least. And I will show you how this procedure works. And I hope you like it, and let's get into it. So, when you want to use polar alignment in SharpCap, I have some bad news for you, because it costs a little bit of money. So it's a yearly license you have to pay. It's $15 or 12 euros, so the amount is not so high. And for me it really improved the accuracy of my guiding by nailing my polar alignment. So that's something to consider for you. When you start your polar alignment, of course, I'm assuming that you are already taking in all of the tips I have given you. So your mount is leveled, it's pointed north, and you're at the correct latitude position.
And I show the AVX here, my AVX mount, and it has these index markations. And basically you have these index markations have to be in alignment with one another, so it's in the parking position and your telescope is pointing north. And then if you have done that and you have connected your camera and also you focused on the stars, you can start your polar alignment in SharpCap. So you press on tools and you go to polar alignment and you get this screen. Immediately it solves the north celestial pole, so it takes a picture of the north celestial pole, and you can press next. And as a second step, SharpCap asks you to rotate your mount about 90 degrees. And I have made a short video to show you how this is done. So basically you loosen up the clutch of your mount and then you turn your telescope 90 degrees, the RA axis of your mount, you turn it 90 degrees and then you re-tighten the clutch. So, and I'm using actually this index markation and I put the screw of the clutch right above or in line with that index mark. So that's the way to do it. And then after that, SharpCap will take a second picture. And it will tell you the polar alignment error you have at that particular moment. So you can see it here, SharpCap is taking a second picture right now and it says that I have a polar align error of about 11 arc minutes. What you need to do then, when this second picture is solved, you can press next. And this is what I really love about SharpCap, what I want to show you. You see, yeah, it has this simple overview actually. It shows the polar align error of 11 degrees in this case. And it just says, okay, you have to turn the mount 4 arc minutes. Well, it's not degrees, sorry, 11 arc minutes. So you have to turn the mount 4 arc minutes to the left and 10 arc minutes up. And basically you will use the Alt-Os and also your altitude screws on your mount for that. So I'm showing the Alt-Os screws right here on your mount. So this will change the position horizontally by just turning on the left and the right knob. So you have the screws, you untighten one and you retighten the other. And of course your mount will change a little bit in position, a little bit to the left or a little bit to the right, depending on which screw you tighten or untighten. And of course you can do the same for the altitude position of your mount. So you have your screw in front and on the back of your mount, and you can just untighten one screw and retighten another screw. And of course this allows you to make a very minor adjustments to your mount in altitude. And of course the largest benefit here is that SharpCap is looking with your camera through your telescope, so it will take a much more detailed picture of the North Celestial Pole. And one extra tip here, when you are going to make these minor adjustments in order to cancel out these 11 arc minutes, so your goal would be to get within 1 arc minute of polar align error. When you're going to change these the Alt-S screws or the altitude screws, you have to make very minor adjustments, because even a minor adjustment it already results in several sometimes arc minutes of changes. So we are really talking about making very minor adjustments. So yeah, you can see here, oh, I went from good to fair again, and you can, I think you get a drift, so you will keep on perfecting your polar alignment until you are at, I'm always aiming for less than 1 arc minute of polar align error, and this really, really, really helped me to increase my guiding, especially my declination axis guiding. Where I always get a sub-mark accuracy or around 1 arc minute accuracy. I think, it is an excellent result.
So folks, I really hope you liked this video. If you do, don't forget to smash that like button and subscribe to the channel. And I'm also curious, what kind of polar alignment procedure and what kind of software are you using to improve your polar alignment? Please let me know in the comment section down below. I'm happy to respond to that. And with that, we're at the end of the video. And thanks for watching. See you later.